What are you anticipating in your near future? Are you looking forward to a new home or maybe a new car? Maybe you're thinking about a new job, or you might be in school even right now trying to get in another degree in order to better yourself. And beloved, there is nothing wrong with any of that. I believe that we should look forward to our future. But at the same time, I believe that one of the greatest things that we ought to be anticipating, that is the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe that's why I forgot what disciple wrote it, but apostle that wrote it, but said that if it be his will, then we will do this and do that. I believe it was James. And so, beloved, we should look at everything in that fashion. We should look at our future, anticipating and desiring that one day we will meet some of the goals that we have set before us. But we should never, ever leave the coming of the Lord out of that equation, to the point where we will not even be expecting his return. And so when he returned, and then there's no expectancy, that means there is no anticipating and no waiting for him. The Word of God says in the 12th chapter, from what we've been studying in the book of 2 Peter, in the 3rd chapter, it reads, "Looking for and hasting," in other words, with a desire of come quickly, "to the coming of the day of God, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved and the elements shall melt with fervent heat." No, we're not looking for the fire that will come upon the earth at that particular time, but what we're looking at the fact that we will be with our Lord. So that should be our anticipation. I like what the Word of God says in Revelation, though, the 22nd chapter and the 17th verse. Look what it says. This is the Spirit of God, and this is, we know, John, who's the Revelator who penned it, led by the Spirit of God, the Spirit of Christ. It says in 17th verse, "And the Spirit and the bride say, Come. And let him that heareth say, Come. And let him that is athirst come. And whosoever will, let him take the water of life freely." And look at the 20th verse says, "He which testified these things said, Surely come quickly, amen. Even so, come quickly, Lord Jesus." Dearly beloved, even the Spirit of God is urging on the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. And so if the Spirit of God is urging the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, so should you and I, who have the Spirit now living inside of us, calling out for the urging of the coming of the Lord, as the word says here, looking for and hasting, being in a hurry to the coming of the day of God. That's what we are anticipating more than anything else in our lives, beloved, is the coming of the Lord. That's not the end of everything. That is the beginning of new life, life in the Spirit, with the one we say that we love, the one that we said we can't wait to see face to face. And that ought to be our desire. That ought to be our anticipation. Patient. That's what we ought to be looking for in our future, the coming of the Lord. That ought to be the staple of our future. That ought to be the hallmark of our future and what we are anticipating and looking forward to. Beloved, that should be our desire. That should be our goal. And to walk that way is to walk a blessed existence. Amen? A blessed existence, because we have something that we're looking forward to. Even as the Word of God says, when Moses and when they were searching for a promised land, but they were searching for a land not made by the hands of man. They were searching for that heavenly home that the Lord had for them. Beloved, let us get busy in anticipating, not being anxious, but anticipating, because we know that it will happen. When? None of us know that time, but we know that it will, and we ought to live as though we know that it will. Beloved, be blessed this day in Jesus' name.